tell Syndrome a god. I'd like to see the look on his face.
No. I may have kept your secret too long. But now you will keep our secret.
Huh.
Ah!
Still can't believe he ate it. Okay, I know I saw something.
I saw it too.
Rhea did say the Jotunheim Realm Tower was missing from the lake. But maybe only kinda?
Very strange indeed.
If you dock on this beach. Mimir, why did you say Tyr felt responsible for what Odin did to the gods?
There was an incident shortly after the forging of Mjolnir, when Tyr arranged a diplomatic meeting between Odin and the giant kings. Well, this was when the Long War was young, and victory was still a thing dreamed of, and the Jotnar might have tipped the balance between Aesir and Vanir. Odin had persuaded Tyr that the hammer was merely a deterrent, a means to broker peace from a position of strength. Tyr was hopeful to convince all parties they would prosper best through peace. He knew the giants were deeply concerned about the hammer, a super weapon in hands they did not trust. But they trusted Tyr. Tyr always believed the best in people, and taking Odin at his word and his desire for peace, he brought the Raven King to Jotunheim. From there, things unraveled quickly. The giants anticipated Odin's trickery and exposed his true agenda to spy and steal their secret wisdom. With magics, they expelled Odin from their realm and cursed him never to return. Frustrated, Odin visited his fury upon the giants of Midgard. You know what? I'll tell this one later.
Boy. Boy.
Hold on. Let me read this.
Hey, look who's back up and about. Didn't I tell you it'd be fine?
Oh, almost forgot. Brock, this is our new friend Mimir.
We've met.
Oh, why didn't you say so?
He knows why.
I know why.
You know why.
Quiet. No more of this.
Know what? I'm sorry I brought it up. Can't you and Sindri just patch things up? Whatever happened...
What are we talking about?
Read it.
Sir. These runes read death inside.
I need that alchemist for something I'm stewing up for you. If in your smarts, you'll find him.
So, Brock said his friend was dwarven like him, wearing a green ring.
Look if you wish. I will be gathering resources for our journey.
You don't want to help him?
No.
Why not?
Because I do not run errands.
That's a soul eater. If that kills us, that's it. No Valhalla, no hell, no afterlife, ever.
It does not attack.
Oh. Mom made them sound more dangerous than that.
Then do not drop your guard. Come.
Of them could be Brock's friend. They probably have useful loot too.
Look here.
Dwarven, but no ring. One of his crew?
Scorch marks. There, along the floor and wall.
Weird. I guess we keep looking.
We?
I mean, I'll keep looking. attached to the Soul Eater. Well, we know what happened to Invari now. We can just go tell Brock. I don't need to fight it, right?
No, we will fight it.
But why?
Because you are frightened of it. Stay quiet. Make no sudden movement. Thank you. You are stronger than you know.
Thank you, Father. Let's see if that's the alchemist's drink.
Green ring. Dwarvish inscription.
The alchemist. But where's the rest of him?
Ashes, most likely.
Soul Eater got him. I guess we should bring this back to Brock.
Can you read it?
Yes, sir. The runes were written fast. It spells out Ejim Staney. I don't know that one.
We will ask the blue one.
So now you're interested?
We found his alchemist. A reward he promised.
I think you got him. Didn't even break a sweat.
What'd you find?
Your alchemist.
I'm sorry, Brock. The hand is all we could find. Still wearing the ring. There was a soul eater inside. And, well, it must have burned away the rest of him.
Suppose you'll still be wanting some compensation, huh?
Naturally.
Naturally, he says. Miani Feruxi. I'll take a closer look at this here ring. Maybe Angar left a bit of magic inside before he croaked.
Dwarves can do that.